Hello, dear students. Welcome to Chinese Bridge, Chongqing Modern Culture Exhibition. I'm Yukali.
I'm TJ. 同学们好，我是主讲人涂静。
我是主讲人李苏杭。
欢迎来到汉语桥重庆现代文化展。
来思五多，来思重庆。
Located in southwest China, Chongqing is a provincial administrative region of China, a municipality directly under the central government. It is an economic center in the upper reaches of Yangtze River, an important modern manufacturing base of China, a comprehensive transportation hub in the southwest region, and also an important connection of the Belt and Road.The development of Chongqing's economy has basically formed a pattern of coexistence of agriculture, industry, transportation, and logistics. Chongqing, seen as a mountain in distance and a city closely, is a beautiful place with green mountains, undulating and surrounded by two rivers. Chongqing is famous as not only the mountain city, fog city, and bridge city, but also the city of delicious food.
山，大水，大城，长江奔流，流淌出城市的轮廓，自然的造化，历史的沉淀。孕育了西部的明珠，这就是山水之城、美丽之地——重庆。重庆，古为八国地，后称八郡、渝州、公州。1189年，宋光宗赵敦。先封恭王在即帝位，称为双重喜庆，遂升恭州为重庆府，重庆由此而得名。1891年，成为中国最早对外开埠的内陆通商口岸。抗战时期，重庆为战时首都，是世界反法西斯战争远东指挥中心。1997年，中央批准设立重庆直辖市。面积8.24万平方公里，辖38个区县，常住人口3000余万。厚重的人文积淀，辉映唐风宋韵，梦回明月清霜。八幡寺、钓鱼城、红岩精神。文化系于根脉，历史照亮现实。今天的重庆焕发新的风采。2016年1月，习近平总书记视察重庆时指出，重庆是西部大开发的重要战略支点，处在一带一路和长江经济带的连结点上，在国家区域发展和对外开放格局中具有独特而重要的作用。2018年3月，习近平总书记参加全国两会重庆代表团审议时，要求重庆加快建设内陆开放高地，山清水秀美丽之地，努力推动高质量发展，创造高品质生活。山色映着水光，重庆是一座山城、江城。绿色是大山大水演奏的交响，共抓大保护，不搞大开发，建设生态系统，筑牢生态屏障，给城市种绿，为生态留白。 守护一江碧水，两岸青山。绿水青山就是金山银山，坚持生态优先，绿色发展，推进生态产业化，产业生态化，创造着更多绿色红利。这是城市中的田园牧歌，乡村里的希望舒歌。山清水秀，美丽之地，是这座城市最美的容颜，最亮的名片。查事者治，顺势者赢。创新是新时代最深切的呼唤，大数据智能化成为这座城市的最新符号，为经济发展赋能，为人民生活添彩。电子产业异军突起，智能汽车方兴未艾，智能终端、集成电路、新材料等战略性新兴产业蓬勃发展，新技术、新产品、新业态、新模式不断涌现。沿着高质量、供给侧、智能化方向，重庆坚定前行，因地制宜走好转型路，因势利导打造升级版，经济活力、动力和潜力不断释放。古老的乡音，生动的人间烟火，别样的重庆，韵味悠长。这是一幅生态美、产业兴、百姓富的画卷。一座现代城市，一片美丽乡村。城市让生活更美好，乡村让城市更向往。各美其美，美美与共。这是一方宜居、宜业、宜游的热土，丰富的商业形态，拥挤的轨道交通，直达全球多个重要城市的航线，完善的教育、医疗、社会保障。这里有事业的纵深，理想的天空，动感、时尚、生机勃勃，创造属于每一个人的高品质生活。重庆正在变得更加美好。近者悦，远者来。山环水绕，江峡相拥，道法自然，天人合一。山水是颜值，人文是气质。大美重庆，美不胜收，美不尽言。站在新的起点上，重庆正以崭新的奋斗姿态，拥抱新时代，进行新思想，实现新作为。这就是重庆，山水之城，美丽之地。在这里行千里，可以志广大。
我们现在所看到的，我身后的这个区域，就是重庆的经济新地标江北嘴中央商务区。
江北嘴 Central Business District is the only national strategic financial center in the central and western region of China. It is an international window for the inland areas to open to the world. As the core and leader of the first national new area in inland China, Yangjiang News District, the management bureau of the third intergovernmental cooperation project between China and Singapore is based here. 江北嘴 CBD reaches a strategic height that is difficult to reach for other regions in central and western China. As a result, it is regarded as 陆家嘴 of Shanghai in upper reaches of Yangtze River and the third financial district of China. Numerous skyscrapers rise from the ground. More than 2,500 enterprises of various types and 500 financial institutions gather here.
In the heart of southwest China, surrounded by the sprawling Jilin and Yangtze rivers, lies the city of Chongqing. Also known as the bridge capital of China, this commercial and industrial hub boasts more than 14,000 bridges and deep tunnels. However, huge prosperity wasn't always the norm for Chongqing. In fact, as short as 100 years ago, long before any bridges spanned across the waters, you would have seen a completely different world. The land and its people suffered from a poor and underdeveloped life. Because of its mountainous terrain, steep slopes and broad rivers isolated the city from the rest of the country and limited local people's opportunities. Transportation came a massive challenge. Despite that hurdle, the people of Chongqing never backed down. The shift from impoverishment to fast development like nowhere else in the world. What once was near impenetrable terrain now has become a hub of connection. The number of bridge projects only increased in scale and design. From the world's largest stone arch bridge to 5G wired road rail bridge and everything in between. Arch bridges, beam bridges, cantilever, suspension, cable stayed, truss, and tied arch bridges. They can all be found here in Chongqing. In only a few short years, Chongqing would rise to become the holder of 17 world bridge records, world's longest span steel arch bridge, the longest transit tied arch bridge for dual highway and rail traffic in the world, and the world's first partially cable stayed bridges, and many others. The future of the construction industry in Chongqing looks bright. A rare and complex Hongyang Village Bridge and Tunnel will pass through more than 2,000 buildings. This is a three-dimensional superimposed design of four layers and seven tunnels. Highway and rail transit tunnels, layers of vertical expressway. This is a mega project and these are the people that built it. Despite the complicated geology of the area, this was almost an impossible engineering feat that will become a reality this year. And here is the Baijiuxi Yangtze River Bridge construction underway. It's the world's largest span steel truss cable stayed bridge with two-way 8-lane urban expressway and lower-level rail transit. The main bridge adopts the shape of a multi-curved water drop, which has rich cultural connotation inspired by Chongqing, a city of mountains and rivers. It is the people of Chongqing that changed the city's destiny through tireless efforts leading the city to a bright future, promoting regional economic development and prosperity. With the Chongqing rail transit in full bloom, the city is expanding its infrastructural capabilities beyond bridges alone. The monorails stand as an achievement on its own. Chongqing owns the world's largest and busiest single monorail line in the world. Chongqing has the powerful ability to cut directly into buildings and forests. Where large mountains once stood in the way, the people have now pushed through with deep tunnels and high overpasses along vast landscape. Proudly renowned for its spectacular infrastructure and intricate crossroads, without a doubt, Chongqing has quickly established itself as a huge player on the global stage. In the context of the CCP's 100-year anniversary in July, this accomplishment is unprecedented. The rapid growth only begs the question if Chongqing can go from a poor city to being internationally recognized as the bridge capital of China in as little as 100 years, just what will take place next?
Jiangbeizui CBD borders Yangtze River in the east and Jiangling River in the south. If you need to go to other districts of Chongqing, you need to pass a bridge. There are three river crossing bridges in Jiangbeizui CBD. Huanghuayuan Jiangling River Bridge, 朝天门 Yangtze River Bridge and 千厮门 Jiangli River Bridge. Speaking of bridges, due to the special geographic condition, there is a saying that low bridges, low roads in Chongqing. There are more than 2,000 bridges in urban Chongqing, and about 40 bridges cross the rivers. Besides, the number of bridges in Chongqing is huge, the construction skills of which are grand, and the technical skills are excellent. Therefore, Chongqing is also known as the bridge capital of China. In addition to bridges, another special sightseeing transportation in Chongqing is the Yangtze River Cableway. The Yangtze River Cableway connects Yuzhong District and Nan'an District. It is 1,166 meters long, with a running speed of 6 meters per second, taking 4 minutes and a half to go a one-way running. Its maximum capacity is 65 passengers, and the daily capacity is 10,500 passengers. As an important part of Chongqing's unique 3D transportation network, the Yangtze River Cableway is a distinctive city card.
现在为同学们介绍一座重庆的网红大桥，就是我身后这座千厮门嘉陵江长江大桥。
千厮门 Jiangli River Bridge has a main span of 312 meters. The upper layer is a two-way four-lane urban expressway, and the lower layer is a dual-track urban railway.It is integrated into Chongqing's landscape as a whole in its design, fully demonstrating the beauty of Chongqing. It is adjacent to Hongya Cave, the stilt buildings that mostly characterizes the traditional architectural features of Bayu culture. Classical buildings and modern bridge complement each other, providing a new experience of sightseeing when crossing the bridge. Therefore,千厮门 Jiangli River Bridge has become the most well-known bridge in Chongqing in recent years, attracting tourists from China and around the world. On Chinese National Day or some other festivals, 千厮门 Jiangli River Bridge will be closed to motor vehicles and only allow pedestrians and tourists to pass, which shows Chongqing's humanistic solicitude to tourists. From 千厮门 Jiangli River Bridge,You can see a group of stilt buildings standing on the cliff. This is the most popular internet celebrity site in Chongqing nowadays, Hongya Cave. Hongya Cave, originally known as Hongya Gate, is one of the ancient city gates of Chongqing. It is a testimony of Chongqing's history and culture, as well as a symbol of Chongqing spirit. There are 11 floors in Hongya Cave.It is possible to watch green water dripping through the buildings, visit the old streets to appreciate Bayu culture, watch Yangtze River and Jiangli River meeting, taste Chongqing hot pot and other food around the world. The stilt buildings on the cliffs of Hongya Cave are unique traditional Bayu buildings, established by river, developing along the cliff, scattering high and low, and standing on the mountain.Hongya Cave is endowed with a sense of history, beauty, and commercial productivity. With outstanding scenery, Hongya Cave at night is even more dazzling and fascinating. When all the lights in Hongya Cave is on, it seems to be painted with golden paint. It is like an exquisite oil painting, which allows people to go into a 2D space. Thus, shooting Hongya Cave,has been a must-to-do thing in Chongqing for countless photographers.
Welcome to Chongqing. Get on the subway to the future. Chongqing is one of the world's largest municipalities.With a population of about 30 million people, which is surely enough to make anyone sit up and take notice. Just to put that figure in perspective, it's equivalent to half of the population of Britain, all living in one mega metropolis. So how does a city the size of a country move its people daily? I give you Chongqing's rail network. The masterminds behind these sprawling subway lines have had to deal with mountains, rivers, and many challenging terrains in this now labeled 8D city.
In Chongqing, there is a solution to every problem. Accept it, change it, and master it is exactly what engineers do, constructing a rail network to the future. The monorails stand as an achievement on their own, having the powerful ability to cut directly into buildings and forests. Where large mountains once stood in the way, the people have now pushed through with deep tunnels and high overpass along a vast landscape. The most famous mind-boggling monorail route in Chongqing is the world-famous Line 2. This first line was built in 2005. No, this is not the Walt Disney World monorail that operates inside a theme park. This is Chongqing's world-class monorail Line 2. With speeds reaching 75 kilometers at a length of over 31.36 kilometers, the line has over 25 stations. This technology no longer requires any outside expertise. Chongqing's monorails are 95% locally patented. No station could ever be more popular than the world-famous Liziba Station. This engineering masterpiece looks like an optical illusion, but in reality, the monorail passes through the building. In fact, the building and station were built at the same time. The famous monorail Line 2 continues to create landmarks throughout the city. By 2025, Chongqing will have over 1,000 kilometers of rail transit in operation and under construction. The rail network serves its city as a connection for its people to commute while acting as a hub to all vital areas, airports, businesses, and logistics. These lines connect millions of daily riders, creating new cities surrounding the stations. This 3D transportation grid zigzags across Chongqing's mountainous landscape. These revolutionary lines act as veins of a beating infrastructure's heart that connects everyone together. They will always be a physical proof of an everlasting spirit and determination of Chongqing's people to succeed. The people that power this network daily should also be recognized. These are the true heroes of Chongqing's extraordinary transportation lines. Every station consistently stays updated on the latest technology, including surveillance systems, protecting its daily travelers in a safe and time-efficient way to find their destinations. The average daily passenger volume of Chongqing's rail transit accounts for approximately 40% of the total number of public transport trips. Rail transit has become the first choice for its citizens. This proportion will be further improved to alleviate urban traffic congestion and improve the public's efficiency. Both Chongqing and China recognize the vast advantages of infrastructure investment. Chongqing is building a one-hour commuter circle, which includes suburban railways, intercity railways, and national railways, in addition to monorails and subways, totaling more than 6,000 kilometers. Chongqing rail transit infrastructure is mainly carried out in Chongqing's metropolitan area, where it consists of 21 districts, covering a population of over 20 million people and an economic aggregate of 1.8 trillion yuan. Insisting the core carrier of Chongqing as a national central city. If you think Chongqing has finished its goals in transportation, it's just getting started. Chongqing and China are putting their money where their mouth is and investing billions into the future and its people. If you haven't already noticed this, then you haven't been paying attention to China. Go ahead and underestimate the will of Chongqing's determination. You won't be the first, you won't be the last, but you could be wrong.
人类智慧，星空里最闪耀的光芒，恒久不变。生命不断攀登的向往，让人类文明从物理世界、心理世界 进入智能世界。大数据，智能化，为我们点亮又一缕智慧之光。智慧八方，博采众长。2018年8月，中国国际智能产业博览会永久落户重庆。习近平总书记发来贺信，倡议共同推动数字经济发展，为构建人类命运共同体贡献智慧和力量。一年来，重庆市全面贯彻务实行动，大力实施以大数据智能化为引领的创新驱动发展战略行动计划。智能产业、智能制造、智能化应用的发展呈现澎湃奔腾之势。智能产业福脉千里，数据的力量、算法的力量、网络的力量，人机结合，虚实之间，知行合一，各类芯片、人机交互屏幕、智能终端、核心元器件、物联网和工业互联网、心平气和网，全产业链支撑起新兴的智能产业。物理空间中的实体机器人和数据海洋中的 AI 算法协同，智能产业为我们拓展的全新维度已然展开。工业革命迭代而生的智能革命，让智能制造日新月异。新一代信息技术，智能制造装备，工业互联网，信息物理系统，搭建起数字化车间和智能工厂。得益于智能化赋能，产业加快转型升级，重庆这座制造业重镇焕发新的蓬勃生机，在高质量发展道路上阔步前行。协作全球产业链，造福更多消费者。智能制造激发数字经济与实体经济融合发展的强劲活力，为经济增长培育新动力，开辟新空间。智能化应用催生无限可能的智慧城市。在天空，我们站在新的高度，看到一个更美的世界。在大地，我们架设数字的桥梁，大地给予我们更慷慨的馈赠。智能化政用，连通信息孤岛，突破数据壁垒。大数据赋予城市新生命，大城智管破解城市难题，愉快办，愉快融，让便民服务更加精细，更加高效。智能化商用，让贸易与服务无障碍的发生。由社会信息化带来的跨界融合，唤醒市场新的需求，给予产业新的光亮。智能化民用带来更多时间、空间和愉悦。在重庆精心打造的李家智慧生态城，向我们展示出一个智慧之城、未来之城的美好雏形。智慧生活、智慧生产、智慧设施，让城市的边界无限扩展，让人们的生活更精彩。2019年4月，习近平总书记亲临重庆视察，要求继续高标准办好智博会，深度参与数字经济国际合作。数字产业化，产业数字化，今天我们再次汇聚重庆，共同推进数字经济国际合作，共享共赢，数字经济健康发展。 为经济赋能，为生活添彩。让我们携起手来，共植智慧之树，点亮智慧之光，拥抱智能新时代，开创智慧新未来。
We mentioned before that Chongqing is a city of delicacy, right? Let's start a delicious tour in Chongqing in the following time.
Chongqing, located in the edge of eastern Sichuan Basin, or around the mountains, which is also called Mountain City. Water vapor formed by evaporation is not easy to diffuse due to Chongqing lies at confluence of the Yangtze and Jialin River.That arouse a lot of water vapor gathered in the air. Therefore, Chongqing is called Wudu, the city of fogs, as well. This reason of geography and weather formed the dietary habit of eating spicy food for Chongqing's primarily humid climate, with its effects of warming body and driving cold. Particularly, hot food.Is one of the most representative food of spicy food. Hot pot, a Chinese cuisine, has been survived almost 2,000 years. This traditional food has been created by Chinese from the Warring States period. In Song Dynasty, pottery is the most original container for eating hot pot. It was extremely tasty foodas a well-known royal counter delicacies was popular in Qing Dynasty. Our passion for hot food is increasingly from ancient era, even now. Why so many people they are obsessed with the hot food? The primary reason must be its variety that meets the taste of most people. There are various optional types for consumers. With the development of hot food,Not only spicy pot, two flavor pot, and tomato foundation pot is provided as well. That consider of the consumer do not adapt with spicy food. Secondly, the advantage of food variety. Consumers save themselves by boiling foods with their appetite. More importantly,The consumer follow rate of eating hot food reaches a peak in winter, usually for best effects of warming frozen body and driving cold. You will feel a stream of a warm air from head spread out to your toes after you eat hot food. It is the best choice of dishes in the winter. Additionally,As you see, when we're eating hot food, usually we sit around the table, talking and eating together, and portray an image with full of delight and laughter. A meal, whatever, for friends or families, hot food always be the best option. When night falls down, inviting a friend or two, sitting around hot food,and drinking beer under the moon. That is a common form of meeting friends in area of Sichuan and Chongqing. The most fanatical city of hot food is Chongqing, where produced the most authentic hot food. It can be seen everywhere in this city. It is just like a born habit of eating hot food for Chongqing people. Everyone likes hot food.It is making a wonderful life for us. Every night, hot food like the bright night embellish this city with its boiled enthusiasm. Numbing, spicy, fresh, and fragrance. These four flavors capture a great throng of consumers. It can stimulate spicy taste by blending of Sichuan pepper and chili that enrage the aroma and also take effect of driving cold. Chongqing hot food grasps the essence of numbing, spicy, fresh, and fragrance. By this way, Chongqing hot food captured numerous people's taste and be well known across the country. You can boil every food in hot food. They are the likes of pig brain, duck gizzard, and cow stomach and throat. All popular additions to firing Chongqing hot food. If nan min, spicy, fresh, and fragrant is the soul of a hot food. Meanwhile, the fresh ingredients is its blood. Serving these ingredients after repeated clean and processing, it tastes supreme delicious after cooked in a boiling hot food. It's a unique taste that no other cuisine can compare with. Chongqing hot food is a reputed signature and a beautiful scenery as an intangible asset for Chongqing people. A common saying, you have never been to Chongqing if you have not eaten Chongqing hot food when you be there. A hot food contains abundant ingredients in a boiling temperature. Chongqing people boiled a tireless legend over and over again. This legend is Chongqing hot food.
后继的味美诱惑。每年农历四月中旬是收获油菜籽的时节，公叔挥舞着镰盖敲打刚刚收割的油菜杆，借着给力的阳光，需要及时把金黄的菜籽粒打出来，晒干后才能让油菜籽在储藏中不会因发热产生霉变。而油菜每年花季到来时，它们将在大自然的安排下举行一场为期20天左右的黄金盛宴，浪漫而清新。2个月后，他们便结籽成熟。公叔今年种植是为最上乘的花菜籽，产量低但油品极佳，这是餐桌更为青睐的食用油原材料。晒干的菜籽粒最终将会送到镇上的炼油加工房，这是让他们实现华丽转身的舞台。800度高温的火炉锤炼后，激发出菜籽粒特有的植物清气，可以获得极致的草本清香。通过压榨，释放出清香翠绿的出油脂，在自然条件下进行冷却，油脂中的植物纤维得以沉淀，也能挥发掉让人不爽的植物清气。而当过滤后金黄液体喷涌而出，让人充满兴奋感的黄色诱惑，这是让餐桌美味丰富起来的源泉。液体中的不饱和脂肪酸与维生素 E 可以让人体保持年轻态，无论烹炒中的麻辣鲜香还是油炸中的清爽酥脆，油脂的纯正浓香很重要，也是让食物华丽转身的关键。对于麻辣火锅来说，一滴上品的油同样很关键，激发出食材草本清香的同时，也能保存食物的本色味道。需要旺火熬炼至280度，彻底的激发油脂植物清香，自然冷却至180度左右，取葱姜植物辛香，而豆瓣、糍粑辣椒是让底料醇香鲜美的关键。在油温督促下，它们将释放出各自酱香诱惑与鲜辣生香。而辣椒曾经只是作为一种观赏性的植物，从美洲
一路旅行到中国，巴蜀大地用近300年的真爱呵护，让它滋润绽放。采用辣椒素高达27%的二荆条干辣椒，才能将清香淡雅的油脂推向火辣高潮，让辣元素极致发挥。火锅中的麻，是借助花椒中的芽椒酰胺，刺激舌黏膜及触觉神经。貌似50赫兹频率的震动按摩，使双唇如跳舞般狂野。所以，诚邀有御膳贡品地位的汉源贡椒入主底料中，才能让麻辣完美升级。当麻辣椒香扑鼻，就需要请出各位植物香料登场，他们的友情助阵，才会让一锅底料味香非凡。而剩下的一切，就需要交给时间来慢慢发酵。48小时后，各色食物本味获得充分释放，取浓香油脂以醪糟、冰糖提味，高汤增鲜，一锅浓香醇厚的锅底才可以上桌。以植物本色汇聚出的麻辣鲜甜，可以将任何食物化为经典。无论涮烫传统老三样的脆爽绵烂，还是烹煮脆嫩清新的蔬果五谷，都足以让人欲罢不能。
我们小的时候都吃那个重庆老火锅长大的，他为啥是九个呀？因为原来小的时候哈，那个时候重庆老火锅，他一桌人坐两家人，我们是一家人，那边是一家人，他九个，我吃了几个，你那边吃了几个，各吃各的，好，他互不干涉。荤菜要坐中间，好，两边用素菜围起慢慢吃，他吃到后头越吃麻辣香味都吃出来。
九宫格火锅是重庆火锅的最初代言，粗犷豪放是重庆老火锅的性格，而九宫格是中国书法史上临帖的一种界格，也曾被作为一种益智游戏，但用于火锅，当年却仅仅是为了节约成本，这是山城人民的聪明智慧。在物质不太富裕的年代，拼桌绝不会觉得尴尬，吃得热闹的同时，还可以给更多人享受美味的机会。
我们现在说的火锅呢，是指的上个世纪30年代重庆开始的。重庆是一个码头城市，有很多船工，劳动量很大，就需要一些这个能够补充热量的一些食品。而火锅呢，它就具有这么一个特点，它非常热，非常烫。另外呢，火锅主要主食的是牛的下水，它的价钱都非常便宜，也适合船工们的这种经济水平。我们说起源呢，就是从船工这个角度来的。但是呢，现在有一种另外的说法，就在重庆南山一带，从贵州那边运油到重庆来，这油在南山一带宰杀，在那个地方呢，就形成一种油的下水的集市，给火锅提供了非常便宜的原材料。所以现在的重庆那边，一个就是水派火锅，就是指的船工创造出来的；另外一个叫陆派火锅，就是指的是从贵州一带运油进来产生的这么一种火锅。
这是一家开在大山深处的火锅，距离繁华40公里之外，但这不妨碍成都吃货们对火锅的钟爱。翻山越岭也会来到这里，体验在这天地间的热辣与诱惑。当夜幕降临，各种忙碌的身影围绕美味的上演而忙碌。今天的火锅草根风格渐渐褪去， 各种现代设备的运用，将美味的历史跨度感骤然拉开，让曾经的草根角色华丽转身。各种热闹的场面将麻辣诱惑推向高潮，喝酒谈天，猜拳行令，火锅给了他们最畅快而美好的瞬间。马与辣相逢下道出的醇厚鲜香，可以让味蕾欲罢不能，同时也能为身处湿润潮气下的身体祛湿排汗。这是麻辣火锅一生最为彪悍的奉献。
我们做的呢是炉排火锅，炉排火锅呢，这是一种马蜂文化，马蜂文化路线。马蜂文化讲究就是，这个火锅它就在这个陆地上，在这个山林，在山间田野当中。
围炉俱炊欢呼处，百味消融小釜中。清嘉庆皇帝登基，一场气势恢宏的千叟宴，是天子借1500余口铜鼎火锅对盛世进行了表达，从此也开启了火锅的传奇之旅。历经千年，围炉而聚的方式已然百锅千味。
开放以后，火锅店大量兴起以后，成都的火锅变得非常丰富多彩了。我们经常说一句笑话哈，天上飞的除了飞机，地上的四条腿的除了板凳不足而外，其他都足。
熊熊烈火烧出天下美味，滚滚红汤煮尽人间沉浮。当迟暮落尽，灯火繁华处，在这一趟一涮推杯换盏间，放下人间喜怒悲欢，洗尽孤独与彷徨，留下的还是火锅的味香与繁华记忆。时光流走，曲终人散，沸腾间把欢乐与美好装满，幸福带回。
听完这些介绍，您是否已经开始迫不及待了呢？今天就让我来为您揭开重庆火锅的神秘一面
纱。来，跟随我的镜头。
如果说火锅底料是火锅的灵魂，那么火锅蘸料就是火锅一件漂亮的外衣。下面我就来教大家自制火锅蘸料的方法。作为一个纯正的重庆人的话，我来教大家制作最重庆的火锅蘸料的方法。首先取适量的蒜泥，再加上适量的香油。如果你觉得火锅很辣的话，还可以加一点醋，醋会有解辣的作用。你看，这样一份简单的火锅蘸料就制作好了。往往是这最简单的火锅蘸料，可以品尝出火锅最原始的味道。 别的鲜香。
我们的火锅底料是亲手炒制的，通过3个小时的手工制作，24小时的腌制才能出锅。我们在菜品方面的筛选也非常严格，每天凌晨从市场采购最新鲜的。我希望通过这种方式，向更多的人传达中国的美食。